The streets are quiet. Everyone's ill. The coronavirus has us beaten until it's Uncle Ben, your antidote friend. We recommend that you need questions, quizzes, comedies, songs with well-known melodies, answers to your deepest needs, all here with our quiet night in. Yes, welcome, welcome, 986 times welcome, my lovely listeners, to the first of Uncle Ben's Quiet Nights In. Nice to quiet you, nights, or something like that. We aim for this to be a little antidote to the boredom of self-isolation, a cough medicine for your cabin fever, if you will, and if you won't, I don't blame you at all, a titillating tonic for your trapped and topical tensions. Now, we want these Quiet Nights In to be as fun and interactive as possible. Notice I'm saying we, because we do hope that some of you out there will feel like contributing, and generally getting involved. There'll be rounds from our ludicrous pub quiz, there'll be riddles and dingbats and word games and challenges and all sorts of interactive marvellousness. There'll also be a ludicrous radio thriller to keep you on the edge of your safe and sanitised seats. And we'd like you to get in touch, either by commenting on YouTube, sending us emails or WhatsApps, or even tattooing your nearest clergyman and sending him our way. As well as direct responses to some of these quizzes and challenges, you can send us questions, requests, pictures or videos of things you've done, quizzes of your own, anything you like, send us whatever you want, especially if it might entertain or amuse, because heaven knows most of my stuff probably won't. Right, let's get on with it, missus. Here be some dingbats. Dingbats, let's have some dingbats. And if you think that jingle's bad, just you wait for the rest of them. Right, can you name the actor here? And I'm using actor in a neutral way, madam. Just say what you see what you say what you see, etc. I'll give you a few seconds. Do pause the video if you must. Did you get it? Yes, 'tis of course Marlon Brando. See how it works? I don't. Splendid. Right, here's another one. Who's this, eh? Yes, 'tis of course Ian McKellen. E.N. McKellen. You see, jolly good. Let's have one more, shall we? Who on earth is this? Why, of course, it is the wonderful and sublime Angela Lansbury. Angel Allensbury. Yes, dear sweet memories. Right, that's quite enough of that. Let's go now to a round from our ludicrous pub quiz, shall we? Here we go!
Zoomy, zoomy, zoom, we ask you, while have we zoomed into? Zoomy, zoomy, zoom, what a clue, what have we zoomed into?
Right, my lovely listeners, the round of the pub quiz that we're going to feature today is entitled Zoomer Rather Than Later, for some reason. Quite simply, you have to look at these pictures of zoomed-in items, things, etc., and tell me what you think they are. Let's have a little test, shall we? What's this? Yes, it is, of course, the beloved Queen Mother. Did you get that right? Probably not. Never mind. If you did, give yourself a point, even though it was just a test. Why not, eh? Right, let's get on with the proper ones. Number one, what in the name of Hades zoomy, zoomy, zoom. Is this? That's right, it's McCucknall. No, not really. It is a strawberry, a lovely strawberry. Right, number two, what's this? Yes, it's a needle and thread. How did you do on that one? So-so. Oh, dear. Right, the next one, please, everybody. What exactly is this? Have a banana. Yes, it's just a lovely, zoomy, lovely zoomy, banana. It made me word up. Splendid. There we go. Now, what's this next one? What on earth is this? Yes, it's a guitar string. Hope that struck a chord with you. Oh, dear Lord. Right, next one. What, please, is this? Yes, it's a toothbrush. Scrubby, 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 etc. How are we doing so far? Well, let's try another one. What insanely thing is this? Yes, that's right. It's a record, an LP, a vinyl, all the rage nowadays, groovy, etc. How down I am. What? What's this, please? What is this? Look at it. What is it? Can you take a condiment? Yes, it's salt and pepper. Right, what's this one? Strange looking thing. What is it? Yes, it's Velcro. What a rip-off. Okay, next one. What is this? What is it? What is it? It's a nice bit of dust. Nice bit of dust. Dust, dust, dust. In all our homes, how delightful it is. Okay, what's this hideous-looking creature? Stuff of nightmares. Yes, that's right. It is, of course, Katie Hopkins. Although I will also accept a nematode worm. And there's a sentence I never thought I'd hear myself say. Well, wasn't that ridiculous? How did you get on? Jolly good. Right, let's calm things down a bit now, shall we, and have a nice little riddle.
Stuck on a riddle with you. Stuck on a riddle with you.
Riddle me this. I speak without a mouth and hear without ears. I have no body, but I come alive with wind. What am I? Is it Anne Widdecombe? No, I don't know. I'll leave this one with you. Do post your answers below if you wish. We'll give the answer next time. Right, I think it's time for I've Got No Glasses On. This is really quite worryingly simple. I have now taken my glasses off, and I shall be attempting to read, from a distance, the first few lines of, in this case, a well-known book. Can you work out at home what on earth I am reading? Do comment below. Good luck! Right, here we are. God, that's it. Oh, bleeding Nora. Sorry. So blind, I've just knocked the phone over, I'm trying to read from. Right, here we are. Okay. My familiar family rape, Keanu Reeves. And the clergyman respectfully pole dancing is formerly Triple Cum Naismith alone, Alan, running nothing further for more redirect cottaging, Flip Wizard. So I relieved myself pop and some in this rather flag. Well, there we are. Glass is back on now. I'll be quite amazed if anyone gets that. Do comment below if you think you know what it is. Why not, eh? Okay, what am I doing? I don't know. Right, time for another picture quiz, I feel.
Can you name this book or film or thing? Can you name this book or film or thing? Can you name this book or film or thing? Can you name, 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 can you name this book or film or thing? Can you name this book or film or thing? Can you name this book or film or thing? Can you name, 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 can you name?
Sorry, I've played that play for a very long time. It's my favourite jingle ever. Oh, I am easily amused. I wish you lot were. Anyway, can you name the film from this poster background? Can you? Can you? Yeah, it's quite an easy one, that one. It is, of course, Jurassic Park. But how about this one? Yes, 'tis The Conjuring. Spooky. Now, changing it up a bit, how about this book? What is this book? Yes, a long way up there and back a bit or whatever. It is The Hobbit. This is The Hobbit. Well done if you got that. Okay, time for some music now. Let's go over, brace yourselves, to Mad Elvis.
Mad, 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 mad Elvis.
Oh, hang on a watch, hang on, hang on, hang on a watch.
Mad, 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 mad Elvis.
Oh, hang on, hang on a watch, hang on. Hello there, Mad Elvis, and how are you today? Yes, jolly good. Keep taking the pills. Can you name, lovely listeners, the song Mad Elvis is going to sing now? Dear Lord. Yes, it was, of course, and I use the words of course very loosely, the Ace of Spades. Good grief. Here's how it should have sounded. Oh, never mind. Right, time for a challenge.
Cabin fever challenge. Fever challenge. Cabin fever challenge.
This week's challenge is to, within your own home and being safe, etc., of course, I want you to recreate a scene from the movie Titanic. You can do it any way you want, simple, difficult, whatever you like, go mad. Just be safe and do it within your own house. Do please take a picture or a little video of it and send it to us. That would be marvellous. And we'll feature it next time, unless you don't want us to, of course. Good luck!
Cabin fever challenge! Fever challenge! Cabin fever challenge!
Okay, let's take a wee break from puzzling, shall we? And have the first part of our new radio thriller, If We Dare. Good evening, O seekers of the supernatural. O dabblers in the dark realm. Are you listening comfortably? You won't be for long, for soon we shall leave these familiar surroundings and visit the domains of darkness, the sideways and the strange. So prepare yourselves, O tourists of terror, as we cross over to the other side. The first of our terrifying tales is entitled The Mystery of Marblesham Manor, and it begins like this. "'Twas a dark and stormy night."
It was quite calm weather-wise, actually, from what I remember.
"'Twas a dark and strangely calm night."
"There was a huge full moon. It was really quite light out, wasn't it, Margaret? Oh, yes."
"'Twas an eerily bright and tranquil night."
"Not sure about night, actually. It's more like about tea time, I reckon."
"Ooh! 'Twas an eerily bright and weatherless tea time, and as candles were lit and curtains were drawn at Marblesham Manor, a mysterious figure made their way across the dank and desolate moor." Inside the manor, preparations were being made for what, unbeknownst to them, would be one of this household's final ever meal.
"Mavis, remove that cat! I've said it before and I'll say it again. If that cat gets baked into just one more evening pie, her ladyship will have us all glazed in honey and buried in our own semi-detached rice puddings."
"Yes, cook. Sorry, cook."
"As if we didn't have enough to deal with. What with his lordship mysteriously returning early from his trip abroad and not leaving his room since he got back 2 weeks ago. And that parlour maid disappearing without so much as a pardon me for leaving footprints in the wet sand and naught but a pinafore dress floating in the unrelenting bog on a Thursday evening this far into Michaelmas. It's enough to make you want to read the Daily Mail. It really is."
"There'll be one extra for dinner tonight. One extra for dinner."
"And what are you whittering on about now, Simon Shappleton? If there were any extra for dinner, her ladyship would have informed the butler, and the butler would have informed me. It'll be a cold day on Huddersfield High Street before I take instructions from the likes of ye, Simon Shappleton, or my name isn't Anglepoise Stereotype."
"I have not been told. I feel it in my bones. Someone is coming. Someone new. Someone who will change everything."
"You'll feel half a herring of this corduroy rolling pin in your bones if you don't leave off and stop nattering, Simon Shappleton. No good will come from idle gossip, I'll tell you that for nothing."
"They have arrived. Darkness has come to Marblesham Manor."
I believe I am expected.
"There's no need to shout. I'm not blind. Please, come in."
"Oh, yes. Oh, I'll come in." "Itsy bitsy spider, crawled up the water spout."
"You sang?"
"Oh, just a little ditty someone used to sing to me as a child."
"How fascinating. Would you like me to take the lordship up to your room and inform your luggage that you have arrived?"
Other way around."
"What?"
"Other way around."
"Oh, thank you. Dressing myself is becoming ever more difficult these days. Kindly follow me to the drawing room."
Do you think we could go any faster?
Certainly.
Hang on. I need to catch my breath. Haven't a Betsy. I haven't exercised like that in quite a little while.
You ran?
Oh, just open the goddamn door already.
Certainly. May I announce a mysterious, unexpected visitor?
Oh, I'm expected. Oh, mercy me, yes. By one of you.
May I announce a half-expected, semi-mysterious visitor?
Yes, thank you, Chives. Do come in, whomever you might be. It is not a night to be kept waiting.
Why, thank you, Lady Marblesham. And may I say you are looking even more lovely than the last time we met.
Yes, you may. You may also kiss my hand, although I don't believe I've had the pleasure.
The pleasure was all mine.
May I announce a half-mysterious, twice-expected, semi-detached, mysterious non-visitor?
Do get out, Chives, there's a good fellow, and tell Cook we shall be one more for dinner, and it had better not be Tigger's surprise again. Oh, would you care for a drink? I'm afraid I didn't catch your name.
Oh, you can call me Landak.
Handbag?
No, Landak.
Well, Mr. Handbag, kindly take a seat and tell us what brings you to Marblesham Manor.
Why, death, Lady Marblesham. Only death.
Oh, I do beg your pardon. What brings you to Marblesham Manor?
1 hour later, and as the night grew cold and black, the household gathered for dinner. Little did they know that one of them would never eat again.
Mama, is Papa coming down to dinner, ce soir?
Your papa's a lord unto himself, Henry, my dear boy. He has not left his room in over 2 weeks now. It really is getting quite ridiculous.
You and Lord Marblesham have separate rooms?
Certainly. I would have us have separate hemispheres if I had my way.
How very interesting.
This soup isn't very nice.
You're eating the candles again, Great Uncle Warminster. So, Mr. Handbag, tell us a little about yourself and what precisely you are doing here.
Well, Lady Marblesham, you may wish you never asked.
Mama, it's gone dark. The candelabra, it's dark.
I can see that, you stupid boy. There's no need to panic, everyone. I'm sure there's nothing to be afraid of.
Now the fun really begins.
You bang.
Oh, do go away, Chives. Well, at least the lights are back. We can finally see what we're eating.
This gammon's very tough.
You're chewing the rug, Great Uncle Warminster. Henry, don't slouch at the dinner table. It's terribly rude. I do apologize for my son, Mr. Handbag.
Your son has been shot, Lady Marblesham. He's dead.
He's what?
Dead.
Oh, I do beg your pardon. I said I do apologize for my son, Mr. Handbag.
Is Henry Marblesham really dead? Who is this mysterious Mr. Landak? Is anyone really listening to this rubbish?
Find out next time in another thrilling episode of The Mystery of Barbershop Manor. Thrilling stuff indeed. Anyone still awake? Good, good. And by the way, do please comment or send us plot ideas, characters you'd like to be introduced, dialogue you want to be included, or anything like that at all for future episodes of that thriller. It's entirely improvised writing with no planning at all and little thought, clearly, so I can easily incorporate your ideas. So do please get involved. Right, I think we're going to end tonight with a bit of cuddly toy theatre. This is where our adorable animals act out a book or film or song or something, and you must work out what it is. So, can you tell what the cute little critters are acting out here?
Cuteness runs through their veins. They're cuddly toys.
Oh,
they're cuddly toys.
Oh, 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 oh.
Yes, 'twas of course the Fellowship of the Ring. Not difficult, I'll grant you, but very, very silly. More from those cute cuddly creatures next time. Well, I think that's enough for one quiet night in, my lovely listeners. Until our next night together, look after yourselves, stay safe, remain ridiculous, be kind, isolate all your shelves, and always keep 2 meters away from toilet paper. I think that's what they said. And don't forget to comment below or send us things. Do get in touch, and we will see you next time for another quiet night in. Farewell!
Dum 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 d